Dan, what do you recommend to improve my tonality during a sales call?
Exercising helps. Breathing work helps.
Yep.
If you want to train your voice, vocal training would help. Vocal training, I mean you're using your voice, you're practicing speaking from your throat, your diaphragm, right? From your chest tone. So you'll learn almost like singing. It's like singing lessons. And you can practice, right? Because you're training your voice. This is why you hear actors, you hear broadcasters or radio personality.
Yep.
They have a certain voice.
Mm-hmm.
So it is a learnable skill. You could train your voice to be more powerful, to be more compelling, to be more authoritative. You can learn. Yes, we are born with a certain voice, yes, but you can still sharpen your tool to use it, right? So my voice used to be higher pitch in the past,
right?
When I was younger, right? Probably picking it from my mom, perhaps, right? But my pitch used to be higher. But later on in business, I learned the tone, so I learned to lower my tone, lower my voice, speak slower.
Yep.
I used to speak faster, now I speak slower, because people can understand what I'm talking about. I notice when I speak faster, because I try to use that to cover up my accent from the past.
Yep.
Because I thought if I speak fast, then people would not catch that I speak with an accent. So I slow down and I practice and I learn how to pause. Pause. There's a lot of power in silence, right?
Sifu, so then let me ask, let's get really detailed on this because I think some people may not even still get it. I've watched you do it. Do you need to get to the level where you are, first of all, cognizant? Yeah, that means you are aware. Mm. This is something that you actually, you know, it's a to-do, like you must do this every time you do a call, you go and listen to your recording. Number two, how do you know what sounds good, what doesn't sound good?
Easy. You record yourself and you listen to yourself, you like your sound. Most don't.
Do you ask anyone around you, people you trust to be like?
No, they lie to you.
Okay.
They're gonna say you don't sound so bad. No, you don't sound good at all.
Mm.
So the best is you record your own voice and you listen to it. How do you like it? Do you like it? Do you like your voice?
Do you also recommend, now these days we got so much access to TEDx, talks and things, find good speakers that you like and emulate them?
And speaking helps. If you're doing any kind of public speaking training, right, it helps. It helps you to learn how to modulize your voice. But projecting when you're speaking versus on the phone, there's also a difference.
Two differences, yeah.
Yeah, if I'm on the phone the way I'm speaking, it's too much. It's too overpowering, right? That's not good. So the phone is a very, very intimate tool. They could hear your breathing. They could hear like very subtle differences. So it's a very intimate tool. It's a one-on-one kind of tool. So you should learn how to use those type of techniques, right? Pause, asking questions, sigh, or tell me about like little things, but speaking to a group, you won't do that.
Right.
Right. You won't sigh speaking to
a group. But it's the philosophy, the same type of detail, you know, that you would put into public speaking, you would put into the telephone speaking. Is that correct?
Yeah. So just hit record, listen to yourself, see if you like the way you sound.
After reviewing the play.
I didn't like the way I sound for so many years. Now I'm okay, but I didn't like the way I sound. I would listen to myself back then when I was doing interviews and stuff like that. I can't.
I remember I told you the recording I had of the original.
All I could hear is Jackie Chan speaking.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
All I could hear is Jackie Chan. That's it. I was like, oh shit. Right? I cringe. Right? I cringe. I couldn't do it.
Mm.
I couldn't. Now it's okay.